more about facilitating an environment in which they are more likely to wrestle with the ideas and the evidence and come up with the appropriate claims themselves, with instructor support, of course, but it comes from them. And in order for that to happen, I've found that I have to really step back into a facilitator role, and that's hard sometimes.
We developed these curricula that have the students working together in groups in which they are thinking pretty much all the time, and they're asking themselves questions, they're trying to solve problems, and they're trying to get at the same learning outcomes that they might in a general introductory content class, but through a very different set of means. So the means are these interactive activities which require thinking and presenting and questioning without the faculty member telling them that they're getting it right or wrong.
They're working with their peers in groups, which is sort of, you know, hopefully a safe place to say things and be wrong and not worry about it too much, but also, you know, find out right away if you're on the right track or not, either by being sort of corrected by your students or maybe by bringing me over and saying, hey, this is what I'm thinking, does this sound right? And I can kind of guide them in the right direction if they're not quite in the right direction. And so they can get that sort of instant course correction and not go down the wrong path of thinking that they could do if they're just working on their own somewhere in their dorm room.
Instead of telling students the result or the concept or the law or formula and then showing how it can be applied, to actually flip that around and guide students to think about the deeper idea first and only at the end label that idea with a name. So idea first, name later. Delaying introduction of the name can actually help students see the difference between understanding an idea and being in the sense of being able to apply it versus understanding it in the sense of just being familiar with it.
When they're working on the worksheets and they're able to sort of figure things out for themselves, they get much better kind of concrete understanding of why things are the way they are.
I let them play around a little bit with the curriculum, maybe the first activity, and they're asked to get up and share their thinking. And so after they do that once, I say, okay, so thinking about how that felt where you had to share your ideas, how do you want this classroom to be? How do you want your colleagues to behave? How do you want to behave during the quarter? And so we record everybody's ideas about, you know, needing to have a safe space to present their ideas, that there should be mutual respect, whatever. So all of that is written down on a big piece of paper and hung in the room. So there'll be Science Education 201 norms or Science Education 202 norms, whatever. And it's a list of requests for how everybody should behave.
So we try to frame the labs for students up front to let them know what to expect, to try to explain why we're taking this approach. We talk a little bit even about the research base in physics education, describing to students that, you know, experience has shown that deeper, more lasting learning can occur when students have the opportunity to wrestle with ideas for themselves rather than simply being told the answer.
It's sort of one of these things that it seems to take a lot of work in preparation. I mean, especially if you're making your own materials, to develop all of that beforehand. But then once you're actually teaching the class, it sort of is easier because they're doing most of the work in class.
I would say keep mindful of time every day, because it's a wonderful, powerful approach, but it takes time. Usually the amount of time you have planned, it's longer. Because activities, because class discussions takes longer than you sometimes think. So be prepared for the idea that you plan to teach this much and you might end up teaching this. And it comes again with doing it and experience. You start finding out roughly how long it actually each concept takes to understand.
I just feel like there's a lot of growth over this series with that sort of being forced to articulate your thinking.
It's that stuff that's so fun with this class. It's just, you know, being able to see that growth and that being able to apply those concepts to other things.